Gary Palmer, GMB regional organiser.
Nice.
The dispute, well, it's hard to say where we are from where we started. The dispute was not a simple one, but it was basically down to one thing, which was inappropriate behaviour by the local management, bullying, harassment, and failure to follow their own council's policies and procedures. The HGV drivers would often come into the work, and if there were complaints about them, there was a disciplinary or capability process already written out and agreed. But actually, local management decided that wasn't good enough, and they decided to independently, and whenever they felt like, at a whim, introduce round changes, taking people off their vehicles, changing crews around, and sending them back out to rounds they were totally not used to, therefore meaning they were never going to finish the work.
Yeah.
So the residents of this city were already being punished.
So they're going to almost like the private sector.
It is, considering this is a council-owned or local authority city clean, you know?
The public sector.
Yeah, absolutely. It's disgraceful that you're getting managers in here, not allowed. Now, when we bring that to the council, they said, it's okay, we'll have a talk to them. No, you do not talk to GMB members, right? You discipline them.
Yeah.
You put them through capability processes. So we've said, as part of the discussion was, if we're going to put this into a go forward, we need to see a section put into the grievance and policies saying that if a manager steps outside of policy, then he himself can face a disciplinary penalty for doing so.
Yeah.
He has to adhere to the policies
and
treat people with respect.
Yeah.
And that's the key word for it. These guys want respect.
Yeah.
They're experienced professionals who want respect.
Because a lot of the public seem to think, you know, that it's money demands and this, that and the other, which it's not. Do you know what I mean?
It didn't start that way, but the council, inexperienced as they are, they sat in a room with us and said, actually, we think there's a historical issue around pay for the HGV drivers.
Yeah.
Now, as a trade union, of course, representative members, we're not going to, if somebody wants to mention pay, we're going to develop that story. So actually, we said, well, what do you mean? Well, we think they should be moved on a grade. What do you think?
Yeah.
We responded. We said they should be moved up to this grade. This is the grade six. This starts to match with other authority either side of the Brighton, so the pay would be equal, because they're underpaid by everybody else. Yeah. They said, we'll go and look at it. They come back. They agreed.
Yeah.
They said, there is an historical issue. We can put that on the table. So we talked about it, we negotiated, and then we went in, we finished on Friday, we had a sort of accord really that we were going to move forward with this. Monday we went in, all bets were off the table, and they said, we're not going to negotiate on that.
Okay.
Quite rightly we said, well then that's fine then, we'll carry on with our dispute. We've got a lawful notice in which could potentially take us into strike action until the new year, until April of next year. We've just issued 30 more dates of strike, so they're going to go back on Monday to work for 3 days. And if we've not seen a resolution, then we're back out on strike for 30
days. So were you there yesterday, Gary? Were you at the meeting yesterday?
I was. Very shocking, to be honest with you. We thought that meeting was about talking about the issues, although GMB weren't invited to speak, so we did have some reservations about it not being too one-sided. But actually, we sat there then, and Councillor Joe Miller, Tory, decided to use that as a platform to attack the GMB and liken us to a terrorist organisation.
Right.
He mentioned it several times. It's a matter of record. People can find that out on the Brighton Hove website.
Yeah.
The footage is there. He likened us several times. He likened us to having the city, holding the city as a hostage, having a gun to their head, and then made links. The problem with that is we are very worried that those links could be taken up by somebody who actually believes that's true.
Yeah.
And we could see an incitement towards aggravation towards members of City Clean when they do go back out, and they will go back out to clean up.
Yeah.
We've had numerous attacks over the recent month of City Clean workers out on the streets. This isn't going to help, and it was totally unhelpful as to trying to find a resolution.
Yeah. So what would you suggest to the public? What can we do to help? What are the next stages? What are the next steps for you guys?
Well, the next stage for us is we're sat here now waiting. We're hearing in all forms of the media that an offer is being put on the table. Unfortunately, the one people they haven't told is the GMB.
Yeah.
We're not aware of this offer. We're not aware of a meeting we keep hearing about that we're going to be invited to. We don't know. We are ready, and we will go to this meeting whatever time it is, because we want to get this result. But actually, you know, this is a disrespect. A disrespect to two sides if we can't bother to communicate to one side that there's an issue going on.
Yeah.
But what do we want? We want to see these policy change. We want these guys treated with respect.
Yeah.
There's a lot of service that we want people who don't know about the refuge and recycling of the city changing indiscriminately rounds and staff around to make the job even more difficult.
Yeah.
It's a very difficult job. These are professional drivers. Money-wise, unfortunately, if they put it on the table, this union is not going to back down for seeking to find better pay in terms and conditions for our members.
Yeah.
And that has to stay now.
Yeah.
So, but we've decided it's not just about the drivers now. If you want to do that, let's talk about increasing the pay in all public sector workers in Brighton and Hove.
That's right.
So we want to talk about that now. we believe that this is the right time to do it. Otherwise, those people themselves should be making sure that their union, if they're not in the GMB and there are other unions in the council, their unions have got that agenda on the table.
Yeah.
It's our time to take control. We've got to put our desires, what we want back on the table.
So you're right. So what is the next steps? I know you're going back out to do a tiny bit of a clean next week. Is that right? Or
yeah, Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. The last day of this strike is Sunday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, they're back into work. Of course, crews will go out. Crews will go out and there's a lot of rubbish out there. And they'll do their best to start to, clear the rubbish up. 3 days, we're not going to see this city clean in 3 days.
No.
There's a lot of work out there. And there's a, you know, and the residents have been extremely kind and they've stacked things carefully and quite rightly, it's their city. But let's, when we're out there, guys, and we're out there cleaning this, let's remember that respect. We don't want abuse coming towards our members.
That's it. I just took a picture of the sign there. It says, you know, zero tolerance. Zero abuse. You're still getting a bit of abuse every now and then?
Actually, to be honest with you, as you've seen on the picket line today, people going by are very, very supportive.
Yeah.
But you know, we understand when we start to get out there and we go back into resident streets, there is going to be some abuse.
That's the message.
But guys, that will brush that off. We brush it off. We know. In the end, we know. As I say, this will be their streets. Their streets are full of rubbish at the moment.
Yeah.
They're going to be wanting to clean up their streets. They know what it's like. They know how much it smells. But sometimes you just have to take that ultimate action of withdrawing your labour to make in the strongest possible way the point that you deserve to be treated there.
Perfect. Nice one, Gary. Appreciate that a lot. All right.